We are in a profession which is very hazardous for the environment, and nevertheless we have to continue our profession. Doing buildings itself is a non-eco-friendly process. We harm the nature even by digging a shovel into the dirt. None of the materials on earth really belong to us. It is, as somebody said, it is a loan from our future generations. If every architect, every builder, every mason takes that into consideration, then he or she will understand the value of these inordinate materials, that you simply cannot misuse them. You cannot just use it for your luxury, but for your very important functions. I wanted to do amazing buildings with eco-friendly materials. Fortunately, there were not many earth contractors, you know, somebody who would build with earth. Therefore, it was very difficult for me to even find some masons who could do earth construction. I wanted to actually prove that eco-friendly materials can not just build traditional buildings, you know, it can make some very amazing, quite imaginative buildings or forms, and I had to learn it by myself. So this became a habit of me going almost daily to my site and interacting with the masons who are doing it, so that the message is very clear to them of what to do and what not to do, and also to guide them into how to build. So it didn't make any sense for me to even sit in an office and think, okay, the mason might do a good job. That was foolish. So I started a process of daily visiting my site and guiding the masons. And at some point, there were certain areas where I had to indulge in brick making or brick masonry myself. I soon found out that an office is a space which just distracts you from work, literally. Even if you are doing 30 projects at a time, you have to run around these 30 projects to even make sure that straight walls are coming up. You literally have to do that. So what is the point of having an office and then later blaming the contractors? I found that very amusing. Site is my God. The idea would be to get inspired from the site. Now the site had a very particular quality. It was a low-lying site, and there was already an existing small stagnant water body was there in the site. So I had to take into consideration that there will be a water body when it is a heavy monsoons. So that we will live on top of that water. So the entire design started from that particular point. But the client was gracious enough to understand that they have bought a low-lying area and they need to embrace the originality of the site, to understand the nature of the site and live with it. The staircase came as one of the first elements itself. I knew that the facade has to be relative to the staircase also. And also the facade is actually bending over to give some sort of privacy in the balcony area also. So it is not just that I envisioned a shape. It is just that the shape has been giving some sort of function for all my purposes. It is in some sense cutting out the sit-out from the road point, giving us some privacy, some screening. The bamboo facade has not been put just for the sake of having a curvilinear facade. It has been put for a certain functional aspect. The problem people had with bamboo is that people can cut through bamboo and easily enter into the house. One of the workers who worked in Cosford did was that he drilled a long road all the way through a 15 feet bamboo piece. So this gave me the idea that if I can get a steel rod in through, I can even pump concrete through it and make it stabilized. So all the bamboo which you see here are all stabilized and reinforced. This makes it safe and I can use it as a facade. To an outsider, for somebody who hasn't practiced alternative practice, it is very difficult to imagine about other materials. But for me, who started with alternative practice, it was always a part of my regular practice. that my foundation is rammed earth, my my flooring or my roofing is ferro cement shells, my walls are CSEB, rammed earth or mud structure walls, and even my grills are used with adaptive reuse, recycled waste materials and stuff like that. CSEB is compressed stabilized earth block, which is mud blocks compressed and stabilized with 5% cement. It's a technique that has been practiced for thousands of years all over the world, but it has fallen out of practice for the last few, you know, maybe centuries, because of the advent of fire brick and new materials. But the mud brick which we use is very stable and very strong to give at least load-bearing structures of 3 stories. In the west, post afternoons, there will be nice icy cold wind coming, and I wanted to utilize a screen. Yes, we were fortunate to find Whirlpool washing machine wheels. The scrap areas were filled with it. The furniture in which we are sitting and all are all waste materials. This particular seat on which I am sitting is actually made from a large block of wood, which was hollowed out due to natural causes, you know. So if you cut it into two, you get two nice halves. So all of these materials are actually made from waste materials. That is also a principle we follow.